Good day, viewers. You are welcome to another edition of 10 Minutes with Jesus for today. My name is Pastor Idowu Agida Bolurin. I am from the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Osun Province 5. Shall we pray? Our Father and our God, we want to thank you. Thank you because you are the Father of all mercy. Thank you for your mercy that has preserved our destiny to today. Baba, receive all the praise. As you go into your world, Holy Spirit divine, take absolute control. And at the end, let your name be glorified. Show us new mercy today. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. By the special grace of God, I've been ministering on the topic, connecting new mercies. Connecting new mercies. A Bible passage is taken from the book of Lamentation, chapter 3, verse 22 to 23. Lamentation chapter 3, verse 22 to 23. It is of the Lord's mercy that we are not consumed, because his compassion fail not. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. Brethren, mercy is one of the greatest gifts of God to man. It is another virtue that we all need, even after, before grace. Unless a man receives mercy, he cannot obtain grace. Where mercy is scarce, grace may not be found. God's mercy answers for a man in times of need. Every day we all need mercy. In actual fact, when you wake up in the morning, it's because God has renewed his covenant of mercy over your destiny. He has renewed his covenant of mercy over your life. Once mercy expires, a man is satisfied dead. Once mercy expires, a man end up in mortuary. So only a dead man does not need mercy. Why? Because he has passed on to his judgment. And remember, when a man is dead, that's his final. No repentance in the grave. That's the reason why I want to congratulate you. Being alive today is because God renewed covenant of his mercy over your destiny. Mercy is powerful. Mercy delivers. Mercy protects. Mercy preserves. And mercy decorates a man's destiny. Now, what is mercy? Number one, mercy can simply be defined as pardon or exoneration or forgiveness of obvious errors or mistakes. Number two, what is mercy? Mercy can also mean setting aside the right to punish. Setting aside the right to punish. According to Psalm 103, verse 10, Psalm 103, verse 10, the Bible said God did not deal with us according to our sin. Rather, he showed us mercy. Number three, what is mercy? Mercy is inexplicable kindness, the kind of kindness that cannot be explained. Number four, what is mercy? Mercy implies divine blessing in spite of your fault. Divine blessing in spite of your fault. In fact, mercy delivers a man from what he deserves. When a man commits a sin or commits an atrocity and he deserves to be punished, but when mercy zeroes in, mercy delivers that man from punishment. We are at grace. Grace deliver into your hand what you do not deserve. Why mercy deliver a man from what he deserves? Grace deliver into your hand what a man do not deserve. Mercy is very powerful. Mercy takes over at times where prayer stops. I am not casting aspersion on prayer or render prayer. What I am emphasizing is that there are issues that men have prayed about, yet there is no solution. But the moment they press the button of mercy, the moment they operate on the platform of mercy, mercy opened up. No wonder the Bible says, let us come to the throne of grace and obtain mercy so that we can connect our needs in times of need. Mercy is very powerful. Mercy is very profound. Mercy cancels judgment. According to James chapter 2, verse 13, James chapter 2, verse 13, the Bible says mercy triumphs over judgment. Wherever judgment is operating, it takes only the power of mercy to cancel the judgment. Once God pronounces a judgment, that is final. The only thing that can cancel God's judgment is God's mercy. No wonder the Bible says mercy triumph over judgment. Mercy is the appeal God of the Most High. Mercy can bail a man out of any situation. Mercy can triumph over judgment. Mercy can cancel curses. Mercy can cancel oppression. Mercy can cancel evil pronouncement. And I'm praying over somebody over there, by the mercy of the Lord, whatever judgment that may be prevailing over your destiny, we declare them canceled in the name of Jesus. We declare them nullified in the name of Jesus. You need new mercy. New mercy. Mercy, because mercy can expire. Just like the same way a drug can expire, mercy can expire. But glory be to God in the highest. God is saying, according to this covenant word, he renew his mercy over us every morning. Mercy makes God to spare the mercy carrier from his own failure. That's the reason mercy is very powerful. Mercy is very profound. When do you need to apply God's mercy? When do a man need to apply God's mercy? Number one, when you have come to your wit ends and all prayer seems to be producing no result, then you need to cry out for what? For mercy. Number two, when do you need to cry for mercy? When you recall or you have messed up and you need God to deliver you from that mess. It takes mercy to do what? To be delivered from every mess. Mercy turns a man's mess into message. When do you need to cry out for mercy? When the odds against you are really unbearable. When the odds against you are really unbearable, then you need to cry out for mercy. When do you need to cry for mercy? Number four, you apply God's mercy when you have no clue to certain persistent problem. You have no clue to the problem confronting your destiny. You are just moving from one problem to another, and there is no clue, there is no solution. At that particular time, you need to cry out for mercy. When do you need to cry out for mercy? You engage God's mercy when they have told you a certain case has no more solution. A certain case has no more, there is no way out. Everyone seems to have given up. At that particular time, you need to cry for mercy. Maybe doctor has told you your case has no solution. Just go home and die. At that particular time, you need to cry out for mercy, because mercy can turn the situation around. Mercy can prevail over every judgment. When do you need to cry out for mercy? You need mercy as a minister when you are in tight corner to minister. You want to minister and then you are in tight corner. You are weak and weary. You have followed the normal rules. You have fasted. You have prayed. But no unction, no revelation at that particular time. You need to cry out for mercy. When do you need to apply God's mercy? You need to apply God's mercy when your power and your might has failed you. Your talent has failed you. Your gifting has failed you. Connection has failed. Usual helpers are no longer working for you. At that particular time, we need to cry out for mercy. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 1. The Bible says, as we obtain mercy, we faint not. I pray by the mercy of the Lord, your strength will be renewed. You will not faint. You will not be weak. You will not be weary. Mercy will undertake for you. Mercy will promote you. Mercy will strengthen you. Mercy will beautify your destiny. Psalm 102, verse 13. Bible, thou shalt arise and have mercy on Zion. For the time to favor Zion has come. The set time has come. How do you provoke mercy? Fear the Lord. Walk in the fear of the Lord. Psalm 103, verse 11. Then, number two, how do you provoke mercy? Make sure you show mercy on others. Have mercy on others. And number three, how do you provoke mercy? Cry out for mercy. If you cry out for mercy, the Lord will show you mercy. Viewers out there, I pray that the mercy of the Lord will zero in on you. Mercy will undertake for you. Where your strength fails, mercy will speak for you, beautify you, preserve you, protect you, and you will live longer, live well, to fulfill your prophetic destiny. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.